Hey y'all, welcome in, welcome back to my channel. Today I just wanted to give you guys a little book tour of my little reading nook that I made in my home. Also, I have other different areas in my house that I have bookshelves, and I just wanted to show you guys the areas that I have books in my house. I am so excited to be able to show you guys this reading nook that I created inside my home, because I just created a spot that I can just sit, have my flowers in there, have my incense going, have my lights going, and just a mood for books, reading books. Y'all, I am so in love with this little reading nook area. On the days that I have to work like long days in a row, when I get home, that is the first place that I go. I go right there in my little reading area. I sit down in my little chair and I give myself some woosah time. And for me, that is just sitting there listening to a little, whatever type of music I put on my little vinyl record player and listen to my book or catch up on some YouTube that I have not been able to get to because I have been working like long hours at work. I really, really like to do this when I work my 6-day stretches at work, because during that time I'm so tired, y'all. Like, I don't want to read, I don't want to look at YouTube, and being able to come home and have this little area to come to, it just brightens up the rest of my evening, gives me a little time to relax, and give me a time to catch up on my favorite YouTubers, and so I won't get behind on my reading. So with that being said, y'all, to my new viewers, how are y'all doing? Thank you for joining me. I hope you become a part of my family. And to my old subscribers, hey y'all, how y'all doing? I am so glad y'all decided to come back and see me. What are we doing today? Remember, I just said it. We're going to look at my little reading nook. And I just want to show you guys a couple of books that I have on my shelves. Of course, you know it's not a couple of books. I have so many books, y'all, but I want to share with you guys the books that I have on my bookshelves, which will be like a rapid fire type deal thingy. They're not in any particular order. I just put them on my bookshelf according to what I don't know, y'all. What I really need to do is do a book organization video of like putting my books together by either color, author, or however like that. But to me, I don't know, that really does not matter to me. I really just enjoy being able to go to each area that I have books and just look and search and see which books that I would like to read. So I don't know. I don't know if I will actually put them together by color, author, whatever. I'm not really sure. But let's just go into my little book area and let me show you guys what I got. Welcome to my small area, y'all. This is the area that I made for myself to just be able to just relax, read my books, and enjoy being a booker. Yes, y'all, I am in love with this area. So just let me give you a little background on why I made this area. I am a huge book reader, as y'all already know, and I picked this little area to make half my library, home library, and half my journaling area. As you know, I started journaling before I started reading books, but now I'm just combining the two And it has been such a beautiful, beautiful thing, y'all. So, here's the bookshelves, of course. And then this is my journaling table, my plants to my window. And then over on this side is just some of my journaling supplies. And then, of course, my chair and my little table so that I can sit, read, look out the window, and sometimes catch up on my YouTube videos as I'm just relaxing. So what did we come here for today? I just wanted to show you guys some of the books that I have on my shelves. I wanted to show you what is surrounding me every day that I'm in this area, y'all. Oh, so I did this little shelf here so that I can put some books up there. As y'all can see, I have my greenery up there that has some little lights on it just to make it look, feel the way I really want it to feel, like full of green plants. And on this bookshelf, as you can see, and like I said, y'all, they are in no in particular order, but I have a Christina Lauren, I have a ARC book that I got from the bookstore here in Thomasville. I have a book that was gifted to me by Heather Faircloth. And I have another book here called The Stillwater Girls. And my little friend up here want to fall while I'm talking to y'all. I have To Get to the Other Side by Kelly Ollerth, however you say her name. Everything we Never Said. Dreadful. Swap and Smell the Roses. I have Archer's Voice, which has been on my TBR for such a long time. And I really got to get to this Mia Chardon Archer's Voice, because I hear so many good things about this book. And I have started that book, but I just have not finished it. So that is the, y'all, it's been on my TBR for like months. So I must get to this book. This one, Into the Water, it was a DNL for me. I put it back up here on this shelf because I might try to read it again. I don't know. I was listening to it on audio, but it just was not doing it for me. So I just decided to put it down and come back to it another time. Before the Coffee Gets Cold, I have that book there. And of course, I have my vinyls here, which I love my music. As you can see, I got my Whitney Houston rocking right there. And so then down on this bookshelf, like, I have a ton of books, y'all. So rapid fire, we have the Thursday Murder Club, we have Sing Her Down, What Happens to the Bennets, Mirror Girls, From Blood and Ash, Mr. Mercedes, The September House, A Legend, Waiting to Exhale. We have a Christmas book, The Santa Suit, Yes, No, Maybe So, Traitor, Twelfth Night, and we have the Five Star Weekend, The Hotel Nugget, Golden Girl. And here we have All Roads Lead Here, Second Night Stand, The Gentleman Guide to Vice Versa. We got Kindred, The Good Nurse, Sharp Objects, Once More, With Feelings Funny, You Should Ask. These two have been on my shelf for quite some time. I really need to get to those. We have Beg You to Trust Me, and I think this is a series. I'm not sure what book of the series that is. I want to say it's book one. Guys, Girls, Shaughnessy talked about this book. She read this one and she said this book just didn't do it for her. So I'm gonna see what it'll do for me. The 7-10 Split, Summer Romance, Out on a Limb, When I Think of You. We have Liar's Beach, The Body, By a Thread, Another Christmas Book on the Way to Christmas, A Not So Meet Cute. Y'all, I've heard so much about this book. People are actually starting to read this book, and they feel like that is a really cute book. Tilly and Technicolor, The Do-Over, The 7-Year Slip. I hear so much about this book. I want to really get to this book. And then down here, y'all, we got The Summer of Broken Rules, Red, White, and Royal Blue, Curves for Days, The Bookish Boyfriend, The Girls I've Been, The Sweetest Remedy, The Family Plot, Under the Whispering Door, what is this? That Time I Got Drunk and Saved a Demon, Fly With Me, Checkmate, No Stranger Here, Everything, Everything, A Christmas Book, Wreck the Halls. This one is Secret Lives of Bees. Then we have We Could Be Saved, The Emily Wilde's Encyclopedia of Fairies, The Book Spectacular, The Chosen and the Beauty, Bad Moms, Travis, Kaylin, Dusk of Daughters of Dust, The Lonely Heart Book Club, Behind Closed Doors. These are super high up, so I have a few books up here, which I just kind of stacked up here until I do something different with them. We have The Wicked Sister, Where Sleeping Girls Lie, The Younger Wife, The Problem with Forever. We have The Love Con, The Davenports. I did not know that there was a second book to The Davenports. I was very excited to get that book from my local bookstore, and I want the second book even though I have not even read the first book. Out of Office, we got Real Men Knit, Juliet Takes Breath. Both of those books, Real Men Knit and Juliet Takes Breath, those are queer books within arm's reach. One Last Shot. We have For Twice in My Life. We have Chaos Theory, Maybe He Just Likes You. We Can't Keep Meeting This Way, The Royal Next Door, The Wild Lavender Bookshelf. I would pull that one down, y'all, and let y'all see that book. That book is so cute. The cover is beautiful. I have Match Me If You Can, Today, Tonight, Tomorrow, and then a book that I got from Walmart, The Cheerleaders. I thought that book was so cute when I seen it and when I read the little synopsis of it. It was very interesting to me to read. And then here I have like put together some of like kind of like my series books, or like the books that are kind of like standalones but can be read in certain orders as far as series. This is the Elsie Silver series. I have not started on this one yet. The Flawless, Powerless, and Heartless. This is the series that I am so ready to get started on, y'all. I hear so many people talk about this series. It is the Boy of Tommen series, Binding 13, Keeping 13, Saving 6, Redeeming 6, 7, 6, Taming 6. So I think what I am going to do probably for my next TBR, will just be a whole complete series of a book. And that right there might be those books that I will read for the next month. And then I have my Abby Jimenez books here, which is Life is Short, Yours Truly, Just for the Summer, and my Allie Hazelwood books. This one right here, y'all, I just bought this book from Walmart just the other day. Did not even know that this book came out, but it just came out. And I picked it up, and the first page of it, I loved the first page of it. I have not seen too many people talk about this book yet, so I might jump on that one as like a mood reading book, just to be able to get my feelings about that book first. And then I have Love Theoretically. And then this one, y'all, this was the first book that I ever got from Allie Hazelwood, and it has like a number of different books in it. So I really am not sure like what I would call that book, but I will read. For this shelf here, y'all, this is pretty much like my, my fantasy shelf. This is kind of like the only fantasy shelf that I have on my bookshelf that I am looking at. And because I'm not that big on fantasy, y'all, but when I get in that mode, I do want to read a fantasy. So here we got The Iron Flame by Rebecca Yarros. Have not read that one yet. I have The Fourth Wing by Rebecca Yarros. I have read that one. I really did enjoy that book, surprisingly. I have The Wren in the Holly Library. Y'all, that book is so pretty. I don't know if y'all have actually seen that book, but that book is beautiful. Beautiful. Look at this book. Like, look at the size of it and the inside. Like, the illustration of this book is just out of this world. I really did like the cover of this book. I'm not sure even if I would like that book, but just the book cover and the illustration of that book sold it for me. And then I have a Sarah J. Maas series, the Crimson City novel. This is the second book in the novel, which I have the first book on my bed. I'm actually reading it at this present moment, and I'm not quite sure how to say the name of this book, but this is actually not book one, and I don't even know if I'm gonna keep this book or get any of the other books to this series. I will just have to see. I'm not quite sure. This one right here might go to donated to a library or something like that. This here is a book that I bought from someone that I follow, Jessica Cage, on TikTok. She is a indie author, and I was looking at her on TikTok one day while she was actually selling these books, and this is one of the books that I picked up from her, Jen. It's pretty much like a Aladdin retelling. So I thought that would have been pretty cute. I got Bride from Allie Hazelwood. I hear so much about this book. The Hotel Magnificent, Bloodborne, Legendborne, two series. This one is Delicious Monsters. I read some of this book while I was in Walmart, and I decided to pick that one up. Thought it would be interesting for me as a fantasy. And then I got The Kingdom of the Wicked, Sanctuary of Shadows. And this one, I hear Brie, I follow her on YouTube, and I think this is the one, The Battler of Never After. I think this is the first book in that series. She really enjoyed reading this book or a book from this series, so I'll be glad when I be able to actually get into this one to see what her hype is about this book. And y'all, I did like the size and everything of this book as well, so I think that is what really brought me to picking that one up. So this is my fantasy part of my bookshelf. Of course, I have my little camera on that bookshelf, and I have that, my cup, book travert on this bookshelf. And y'all, I am a lover of plants. This one was pulled up out of my plants like by accident, trying to pull off a dead one. So I just decided to put her in water, and I'm gonna just sit her there on my bookshelf. But that is my fantasy part of my bookshelf. Okay, right here is just like a variety of stuff. Y'all, I don't know if y'all like the Heartstoppers or if y'all like, you know, this is like a graphic novel type series. This is actually what got me into graphic novels. I've read book 1, 2, and 3. I haven't read book 4 yet, and I want to get book 5 so that I can complete this series. But I really did like the Heartstoppers. This right here is a book that I picked up from somewhere. It's called Untamed, probably the library sale. And I read the first book to this, What If It's Us, and I loved it. But it was a library book, and when I went to BAM, I seen Here's to Us, so I picked that one up. This right here is a ARC that I got from a bookstore, Such a Bad Influence. Have not read that one yet. And I don't think that this one has actually came out yet. let me see. June 4th. Yes, it just came out this month. So I have not read that one yet. That's my thing. Like, I'll get arts that haven't been came out yet, and I just do not get to them. This one right here is just book one in a series. I don't even know what series this is, but it's called Hate, The Sight, Dark Matter. Heard some good things about this one, Butcher and Blackbird. I did not get the other book. What is it called? Leather and Something. I haven't got that one yet because I wanted to read this one first. This one is Wayford. I got this one just because of the cover, and then the people in the bookstore told me that it was actually a pretty nice book. I have Please See Us, and then I have the Kingmaker series by Kennedy Ryan, which I am such a lover of her books. So it is the Kingmaker, the Rebel King, and Queen Move. And I also have a Jasmine Guillory book, two of them here, which is Drunken Love and The Proposal. So that's what I have on that one. All right, this one is pretty much a series bookshelf as well. And I have not read any, or no, I'm not telling the truth. I have read like one book of some of the series that's on this shelf. And like the Dreamland Billionaire series, the Fine Print, what else is it? Terms and Conditions and Final Offer. I have only read the Fine Print in that series, and I loved it. So I need to get to reading the rest of the books in this series, because Lauren Asher has other books that she has written that I need to get to. And then A Good Girl's Guide to Murder series. I have this series back here. This is the only one that I have read from that series. And the Addicted to You series, I think I've read this one, Addicted to You. I have not read any of the other books in that series, so I need to get to those. And then Anna Hung, Twisted Love. I only got book one and two of that series. I've had these books on my shelf for a while. I need to get to them so I can buy the rest of the books. These books by Anna Hong, King of Wrath, King of Pride, King of Greed, King of Sloth. I am so ready to get to this series. That's why I say, y'all, I have to make me a video where I just only read books of a series, because I have so many that I need to get through. And this is the Shatter Me series, y'all. I have had these books on my shelf for quite some time, and I have almost all of them. I think this is book 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Y'all tell me, please drop down in the comments, let me know, is this series worth it? Is this series worth it? Should I keep them on my shelf? Should I try to read them, or should I just let them go? I started reading Shatter Me. I don't know what kind of headspace I was in, but it just didn't do it for me. So I stopped reading it, and I never went back to it. So let me know, should I read this series? Is this series worth it? And then we have Jada Pickett, her book. I read her husband's book. I had it on audio. So I read her husband's book. I have not had a chance to, and I don't understand like why they put that sticker, like Target put that sticker like right in her eye. But I read her husband's book by audio, and it was his voice actually on that book. I'm waiting for the audio to read for this book. I'm so excited to be able to read her book. Then I have this series, which I hear so many people talk about, y'all, but I just have not gotten to it. And I'm really, really upset about it, because I really want to get to that series. And then I have Girl in Pieces, You'd Be Home Now, How to Make Friends with the Dark. And I think it's another book to this one, but I don't think it's called a series. I think they are just pretty much like standalone books. I'm not quite sure. But that is this show. Y'all moving right along. We have The Husband, Nothing But the Bones. We have a James Patterson book, The Girl in the Castle. And y'all, I was so excited to get this S.A. Crosby book. I hear so much about his writings. So I picked up that one. And I ended up picking up another one from like the Amazon book sale when they had that. This is a graphic novel. I got that. Brooms. I read The Perfect Marriage by this author. And when I seen this book in the cover and things like that, I was like, I have to get that book because The Perfect Marriage was just, oh, y'all, I love that book. I love a Riley Sager book. The only one left. I've been wanting to read this book for quite some time. So I need to get to that one. We have First Lie Wins. And I have Stay Awake. We have, what is this? Bleeding Heart Yard. I think I was just looking at the bargain books at BAM one day and just decided to get some books by authors that I have never heard of. We have Maybe Next Time. We have The Vicious Games. We have Love Letters Dead. I didn't even know I had this one, y'all. Love Letters to the Dead. Wow. I wasn't even showing it to y'all, was I? Sorry. And then we have The Other Half. We have The Places We Never Been. Antoinette. We have Into the Shadows. Welcome to the School by the Sea. We Are Not Them. And then The Outsiders. My daughter like went crazy when she saw this book. She said, oh, mama, I like The Outsiders. I read that book. So I have been eager to read that book. Just have not gotten to it. Like I said, y'all, I needed five of me, but hell, I need 10 of me because I have so many books that I want to read. We're starting from the bottom of the shelf on this side. I have some, I think all of these books, y'all, I think I got it from a library sale at my public library. And this one is a Tiffany Haddish book, The Last Black Unicorn. I have She's Not There, Every Waking Hour, Today, Tonight, Forever. We have Look Behind You, Beartown. I hear so many good things about this book. Bree, a girl that I follow on YouTube, she did her little, what is it called? The mid-year, it just slipped my mind. But it's the, you know, the mid-year vlog thing that's going around. She did hers, and she really did like Beartown. I picked that one up from a book sale at my local library. Then we have You Say It First. We have The Storm Murders. We have Alice Feeney book, Good Bad Girl. We have Stranger in My House, The Broken Girls, and The Cypress House. That is what I have on that shelf. Moving right along, guys. We got The Housemaid by Freda McFadden, which I have already read this book, but it will remain on my shelf because I liked it so much. These are some of the books that I got from the book sale at the book outlet. The Hookup, Dead Romance, Romantics. We have The Dinner List, In 5 Years, Flock, Wild Love by Elsie Silver. We have The Measure. Of course, we have another Freda McFadden book, which is The Housemates Watching. I have A Flicker in the Dark, Play to Win, Business Not as Usual. Then we have The Prince in the Apocalypse. And again, like I said, y'all, I got another S.A. Crosby book, Tears, Razorblade Tears. I have Queenie, and I think this one right here is actually going to become a movie. I have to really look into that. I have The Perfect Escape, One Weekend in Paradise, Everyone's Thinking It. We have Love Radio, The Good Side, Gull Island. I thought that one looked pretty interesting. Me and Faith got that one from BAM. We have The Last Thing He Told Me, Nine Lives. I thought this one was really pretty. It's called Behind the Scenes. Then we have a Rebecca Yarros book, In the Likely Event. And the last one on this shelf is Our Crooked Hearts. Guys, for this show, I have The Blackbirds. We have Tell Me, The Black Queen. We have Tri-Sick Venom. This is a Penelope Douglas book. We have Punk 57, The Other Black Girls, 5 Years From Now, The Unexpected Everything. The Sun is Also a Star. We have the first book to the Brutal Prince series. Who Put This Song On? Monday's Not Coming. Fangirl Down. We have Patterns of the Sand. Song of Solomon. I had been recommended this book for quite some time. So I decided the last time that I was in the bookstore to pick this one up. It's a Toni Morrison book, Song of Solomon. And I just hear that this author has like very deep books. Like, you have to be in the right mind space to actually read her books. So this one is going to have to wait until, I don't know when, but I am very excited to read this book. I have Truly, Madly, Deeply. Y'all, I thought the cover of this book was gorgeous. I went in the bookstore. I went in the BAM. I seen this book a couple of times. And I was like, the cover is just really reaching me. So I picked it up the last time I was there. And then I have The Float Plan. One of them, y'all, I got from the thrift store. And I did not remember or realize that I had already got another one from like the book sale at my public library. To the last shelf, we have a Dolly Parton and James Patterson book, Run Rose Run. Caroline, Blue Smoke, another James Patterson book, Private Games. Play with Fire, Still Breathing, The Pregnancy Test. The Downstairs Neighbor, The Last One, Girl Unframed, Christina Hanna book, Magic Hour. We have If I Can Turn Back Time, Root Magic, Deep Blue, and then we have Kiss, The Kiss Countdown. Heard so much about that book. We have The One Night. We have The Sweet Spot. We have Always Unique. It's Not Summer Without You. Time Our Lives. Always Never Yours. Last book shelf on my shelves. Last but not least. And I think I'm going to change the books that I have up here, because these are really not the books that I wanted to be featured on the top of my bookshelves. Like, I have those featured on the top of that book, that side of the bookshelf. And I don't like the ones that I have featured up here. So I think I will change them to something, I'm not sure. But we have a book called Sweet Success, Hate to Love You. Y'all, I love to look at this movie. After, I have After here, and I have After We Collide. I think this one right here was the actual first book. They are so thick. I love this movie. Have y'all seen this movie? What do y'all think about this movie? Tell me in the comments what y'all think about this movie, because Yolanda's journaling was crazy about this movie. And then I just have some of my little journaling stuff there, which are just printers, labels, and then these are just things that like I make holes with and tabs. Y'all, I picked up A Certain Hunger, and after I picked it up, I realized that a YouTuber that I follow, she just did not like that book. So hopefully I will enjoy or not. So The Hunger, The Certain Hunger, and then I have the 50 Shades of Grey series 1, 2, and 3. 50 Shades of Grey, 50 Shades of Dark. Is it Darkness? of Darker and then 50 Shades Freed. My coworker told me about this series. She said it was a really good series. So hopefully I'll be able to get to that series soon. And then on the very top of this side of the bookshelf, I just have like some of my other journaling stuff, which is a camera and then some printer thingies, candle, and of course my flower. All right, guys, so I just wanted to show you guys this little area in my house. This little area that brings me so much joy. I love being surrounded by my books. Y'all, if there's any books that I have showed you guys that y'all have any comments on, any insight on, that you want to tell me about that book, if you think it is a good book, if it's not a good book, feel free to drop it down in the comments. Let me know how y'all feel about any of the books that I have on my bookshelf. I have to get to a lot of these books. I don't think that I will organize these books in any other way. Like I said, I think I kind of like going to the bookshelf and just looking at what I have, what I want to read, and not, you know, just looking by what author it is. I don't know. I don't know what it is. I really don't know what it is, guys. I just like the way I have my bookshelf organized. And then again, I might organize it in a different way. But as far as like color and this, that, and the other, I think I kind of like tried to put, you know, colors together to a certain extent. But not to have the rainbow effect, because that really does not matter to me. And then later on down the line, I don't know, maybe it will. So if I do decide to do my bookshelf in a totally different way, of course we will do it together. Y'all, this is just one area in my house that I have books. As y'all know, I love books. So this is just one area in my home that I have books. I have a whole room back there that is dedicated to books and journaling stuff. So once I get that room together, I will be able to show you guys that area in my home. But I really think that it will be more geared to like my journaling and Cricut type era. But of course, you know, I will put a couple of bookshelves back there, because I have to have somewhere to put my books. Like, you know, I have to have somewhere to put my books. So I have like a bookshelf like right behind you guys, and then I have a bookshelf down the hall, like when it, you know, the wall of my hall, I have a bookshelf there. I have a shelf there, and then I have a bookshelf cart in my room. My little entertainment set here beside me, I have books in there. And then my little mini refrigerator that I keep all my little non-soda products in there, down to the bottom of that. I have books down there. So like, this house is full of books. That's why I say I think I probably need to do an unhaul of some of these books that I know I will not read again or will not recommend to somebody to read. And then all the others are books that I know I want to read again, or I would just want to keep on my bookshelf that I could recommend to a friend when they say that they need something to read or they want to get into reading, with which I have been getting that lately. And it has just been blowing my mind. It has really been blowing my mind, and it has really been bringing me so much joy to be able to share the joy that I have for books with other people. And they're actually enjoying the book. So, of course, as you know, either they're gonna enjoy or they're gonna DNF it. But it just brings me so much joy to be able to share the love that I have for books. Like I said, y'all, the community that we have grown is awesome. It's awesome. So the one that I have down the hall, the bookshelf and the shelf that I have down the hall, I really do think that I'm going to make that one like my library, where those are the books that I will recommend to somebody to read. And if they don't want to go buy the book, I'll be like, well, I have it if you want to read it, but please take care of it and return it. That is my main thing, y'all. That is the main thing that I am so concerned about. I love to share my books. I don't mind sharing my books. Now, the ones that I tell you I don't care if I get them back or you can have that book, that is fine. But if I say I want that my book back, please, please, please give me my book back in good condition. Please give my book back in good condition. When I lend out a book, the first thing I'm going to be like is, hey, just like the library, you bring this book back in the same condition that you got it from. If not, what does the library make you do? They charge you for it. So yeah, guys, so I am so excited about that, and it's just growing, and the one thing that I am going to make in the future, once I'm able to, like, I got some things in plan which I'm not going to share at this present moment, but once the things that I have in plan go to plan, I am going to have like a whole sunroom. Y'all know what I mean by a sunroom. A whole sunroom just dedicated to my journaling, my, making of the t-shirts and stuff for my family and for my books. And I am so excited. My plants, all of the things. Y'all, I'm so excited about it. I'm so ready for it. And when it does come, I might just take you guys along with me throughout the process. Don't quote me. Don't look for it, because I'm not quite sure when it will happen or when I will start sharing it with you guys. But just know that I am looking to make me just a huge sunroom that we can just enjoy each other in that area, read books, talk about books, and just enjoy. And hopefully once all that happened, I can actually start up a book club, and that could be one of the places that I invite people to come, which will be my home for like book club meetings, or to share or whatever about the books that we are reading or have chosen to read and things of that nature. So guys, this is the end of this vlog. As y'all can see, I'm holding on to my little cuddy here. What is this, by the way? It looks like it's probably a drink. I don't know. But it's just comfort for me sometimes. Like when I'm reading or listening to my audiobook, I'll just hold on to this little thing. But anyway, guys, if you have not subscribed to my channel, I suggest that you subscribe to my channel. I put on a vlog every Wednesday and Sunday. And of course, you know it is all about books. I might stick a little lifestyle in there every now and then. I'm not sure. But I love books. And I love sharing my books with you guys. I love sharing my thoughts with you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Any comments that you guys would like to leave, please leave them down below. I will get back with you guys. And I just hope you enjoyed the video. Bye, guys.